In this segment, we'll talk about if a system of equations can have more than one but not infinite number of solutions. We already talked about that if a system of equations like AX equal to C, is consistent, then the only two possibilities are it has a unique solution or infinite number of solutions. We cannot say that, hey, it has only five solutions or six solutions or seven solutions. We cannot choose a number which is finite other than one. So let's see for consistent system of equations. Let's see how do we prove that we cannot have just a finite number of solutions greater than one. Let's suppose somebody says, hey, you know, I know that y and z, these are the vectors. So let's suppose this is an n by n matrix, this is n by 1, and this is n by 1, and let these be column vectors. So let's suppose somebody says, hey, let y and z be the solution to this set of equations, ax equal to c. So somebody is giving you n equation and unknowns, and you say, hey, I'm finding two vectors to be the solution, y and z. And what we want to be able to show is that, hey, it is not possible to just have two solutions or three solutions or four solutions. It has to be infinite if we have more than one solution. So if y and z are solutions to ax equal to c, that means that a times y has to be equal to c, because we just said that y is the solution to the ax equal to c. And a times z will have to be equal to c, because z is also a solution. Now what that means is that if I look at this particular set of equations, I'll have r times a times y will be equal to r times c. So if r is a scalar, I can multiply both sides by r. R is a scalar. And what I do is I multiply this one by 1 minus r. Because r is a scalar, 1 minus r is also a scalar, and it's a perfectly good scalar to use. So I say a times z is equal to 1 minus r times c, like this. So once that is happening, let's see what we get by, now we have these two sets of equations, 1 and 2, and we can add 1 and 2. Let's see if we add 1 and 2, what we get. We're going to get r times a times y plus 1 minus r times a times z is equal to r times c plus 1 minus r times c. 1 minus r times c. And what I can do is I can take a common here, and I'll get r times y plus 1 minus r times z here will be equal to r times c plus c minus r times c. This and this cancels, so that's equal to c. So what you're basically finding out is that for that a multiplied by this is equal to the right hand side vector here, that means that this is a solution. If y and z are solutions to ax equal to c, then this is also a solution, because it satisfies a times some vector equal to the right hand side vector. But we can very well see that here, if this is a solution, r can take any value. R is a scalar. R can take a value of 2, 3, 5, 6.5, 1 billion, 2.2 billion, whatever value which you might want, whatever real number which you might want to choose for R. So that means that I'll have infinite combinations of Y and Z which are going to give me the solution to AX equal to C. So that's why it's not possible to have finite number of solutions, which is a number greater than 1. You can have no solution, unique solution, and infinite solutions. You cannot have two solutions, three solutions, four solutions, or any finite number other than 0 or 1 when somebody is telling you to solve n equations and unknowns. And that's the end of this proof, and that's also the end of this segment.